Namaskar friends, this is NJ, your host on this channel. In this video, we are going to have our discussion on the concept of foreign settlement, or to be more precise, the prospects of fortune awakening away from your birthplace. Because friends, astrology is a spiritual science. Like any guidance which you receive from astrology is meant for your overall development, success and prosperity in life. So the whole objective of this discussion is that whether your planetary vibrations or alignments are meant to resonate and function better if you are going to shift or transfer away from your birthplace. Because friends, that is a very normal thing, and it's a very obvious thing that if you're going to move to an advanced country, wheresoever you are currently based in, so moving to an advanced country is definitely going to improve your standard of living. But that doesn't mean that with a better standard of living, you are going to remain and get access to more opportunities. But only if you are going to have that combination in your chart that you are meant to function better being away from your birthplace. So that might give you access to more opportunities, overall, good health, well-being, support of positive people, more opportunities. So that is something which we will try to understand in this one standalone video. Because friends, the beauty of our human life is that definitely we are the only living beings on this earth where our decisions are not based on our instincts or like our genetic code. So like, for example, like you know that goose who fly to the southern part in the winters. So that is how they are instinctively or they are genetically meant to perform. Like the way a bear goes through hibernation at the time of winters. And neither we are like trees that we are rooted at one place and we have to branch out based on our that location only. We have this say and we have this control that no matter how you have lived and you have experienced your past 4 or 5 years of your life, you have this capability and control that the next 5 years you can live the life with the kind of attitude, the kind of lifestyle change which you want to bring in your life, and that also include changing your location as well. So that is something which we will try to understand in this video. Now friends, I actually want to clarify and make this video to the point. Here I'm not going to be emphasizing on the prospects of long distance or work related travels, or nor I'm going to talk about just the settlement. Here I'm going to be focusing only on the prospects of your fortune awakening. Is that meant to happen being away from your birthplace or not? So friends, let's just start our discussion. Definitely, if it has anything to do with your physical presence, so you have to always start with giving attention to your ascendant lord. Wheresoever ascendant lord is going to be going, that is going to give us this indication that are you actually looking at those areas of your life. Whenever we talk about anything to do with the foreign settlement, so definitely the houses which plays a role in our chart are to begin with 4th house, because 4th house is the house of your motherland or the place where you are born in. So we will come to the 4th house on a later part. Now coming to the foreign lands, so you have to give attention to the 7th house, because 7th house is something which is far away and opposite to you. 1st house is you, so 7th house is far away land. So you have to give attention to the 7th house. Friends, 8th house is also very important, because in the older times, 8th house used to be the house of the sea travels, but 8th house holds the key to all sort of transformation, all sort of like the positive change which 8th house can bring in your life. So you have to give attention to 8th house as well. Then comes the 9th house. 9th house is the house of the long foreign distance travels, and definitely friends, here we are also looking at and scrutinizing this whole discussion on the basis of where your fortune is going to shine better. So because of which you have to also give attention to the 9th house. And lastly friends, 12th house, because 12th house is primarily the house of foreign settlement. So friends, whenever we talk about any of the prospects of fortune awakening away from your birthplace, so that's very simple. The first thing is that you have to give attention to that whether your 4th house is afflicted in the chart or not. If your 4th house is going to be afflicted, that is going to give this indication that you might be able to resonate and function better if you're going to be away from your birthplace. That's the one indication. The second indication is that if in any way you will see that ascendant Lord is strengthened, being disposited in the 7th house, in the 9th house, in the 12th house. Now that could happen in so many different ways. For example, if you are an Aries ascendant person and your ascendant Lord Mars is strengthened in the 8th house, that is a very good sign of fortune awakening in faraway countries. Or if you are, for example, a Sagittarius ascendant person and your ascendant Lord being planet Jupiter, is it going to be in a strengthened state in the 8th house? That is a very good indication that your luck might shine better being away from your birthplace. You are a Leo ascendant person, your ascendant Lord Sun is exalted in the 9th house. That is a prime indication that not only you are going to have lot many travels, but along with that, being away from your birthplace could actually give you better opportunities. And there is one more combination as well. So for example, for an Aries ascendant person, if you will find ascendant Lord Mars to be debilitated in the 4th house. So friends, the only alignment and the chemistry which you have to see is that the 4th house is afflicted, which is actually creating hindrances in your domestic environment. So this could be one indication. Or if in any ways you will see that your either your ascendant Lord or your 9th house Lord is strengthened either in the 9th house itself, either in the 7th house or in the 12th house. Friends, when we talk about the planets which could be responsible for that, so definitely you have to give attention to begin with Rahu and Ketu. Now in any way, Ketu, which in itself is a significator of relocation or separating you from your ties. If Ketu is going to be present in the 4th house, Rahu is going to be present in the 10th house, that could be seen as one of the prime indicator of getting success being away from your birthplace. Along with that, friends, you have to also give attention to the planet Saturn as well. And you have to give attention to the planet Jupiter as well. Because in the original Kal Purush Kundli, 9th house of your fortune and 12th house of foreign settlement is being governed and controlled by planet Jupiter. And trust me, friends, unless and until Jupiter is not indicating whatsoever you are trying to and you are aspiring to do being away from your birthplace, if Jupiter is not promising that, so there could be hindrances. And we all have seen all those kind of cases where people, just with this aspiration to improve their work condition. Now this could be a midlife crisis. This could be your moon is afflicted. You're always restless. You cannot be stationed at one place. So because of your restlessness, you moved your place, you moved your location, but that did not actually bring the kind of changes which you were anticipating. So because of that, the point which I'm trying to make over here is that you have to individually give attention to the condition of the planet Jupiter as well. Now friends, specifically for this concern, you have to look at the planetary alignments not only from your ascendant but also from your moon sign as well. So by making your moon sign as your ascendant, now you have to see the dignity of the planets, that what kind of yogas are they forming in your 4th house, in your 9th house, in your 7th house, in your 12th house. And like the way, friends, when I was telling it to you about certain combination, so let's say for example, if you are an Aquarius ascendant person and in your case either your ascendant Lord Saturn is exalted in the 9th house, or you are an Aquarius ascendant person, your ascendant Lord Saturn is placed in its own house in the 12th house. So these are certain alignments where just prima facie by looking at the chart, just with the first cursory sight at the chart, gives you this indication that definitely from a Vedic, astrological or spiritual perspective, your energies can resonate better if you're going to move away or relocate where you're going to be based in. And another thing is that, friends, while doing any of the scrutinization, there are certain alignments as well. Like for example, if you will find a lot of concentration of the planets. So for example, if you will find that three planets are either conjunct on the said houses, which I mentioned, this could be 7th house, 9th house, 12th house. Or let's say, friends, you will find that majority of the planets are concentrated on either the movable signs, which are Aries, like Cancer, Libra or Capricorn, or they are deposited in the dual signs like Gemini, Virgo, Sagittarius or Pisces. So that is also going to give you this indication that just because there are a lot many planets, like 3 or 4 planets are concentrated in the said concerned houses of foreign relocation, or majority of the planets are concentrated in the movable sign. So that is a indication that moving away to the foreign land or being away from the birthplace can actually give native access to more opportunities, a life filled with overall growth and prosperity. And along with that, friends, when we talk about the divisional chart responsible for that, so for that you have to give attention to the D4 chart. That is a very important chart. And then once you're going to open the D4 chart, first of all you have to see the sign which is going to be rising on the like for example on the first house. What is the lagan or the ascendant of your D4 chart? So let's say for example from your main ascendant chart, guys, whatever and whenever you open any divisional chart, you do not have to forget the ultimate truth that you have to see it in tandem, in parallel with the main ascendant chart. So first of all, give attention to that from your main ascendant chart, which house sign has become the ascendant in the D4 chart. That is going to be the first indicator. So for example, if you are an Aries ascendant person and in the D4 chart, you are going to find the ascendant as the Libra, or for example, you are a Sagittarius ascendant in the D1 chart, and in the D4 chart you will see the Leo rising. So that is going to be a prime indicator that yes, from the main ascendant chart, just because the house of foreign settlement has taken the form in the first house in your D4 chart, that could be a very good indicator. And definitely, friends, the house which are important for the foreign settlement, so from the main ascendant chart, the planetary lord of your like house lord of your 12th house, of your 4th house, you have to see their condition and their dignity in the D4 chart. So let's say for example, even if in your main ascendant chart you will see that your 4th house is badly afflicted, and the 4th house lord from the main ascendant chart is in a equal state of debilitation or agitation even in the D4 chart, so that could be a prime indicator that yes, moving to the foreign land or being away from your birthplace, you know, derooting yourself from your birthplace can actually give you more access to better opportunities and a better life. And definitely, friends, not only that, you have to also give attention to that whether Jupiter is giving more strength to your 4th house in the D4 chart, or it is giving more strength to the said houses of foreign settlement, 7th house, 8th house, 9th house, 12th house. So that is how, friends, you have to do an analysis and you have to scrutinize the chart. So friends, the summary of this whole discussion is that while trying to find out your prospects of your fortune awakening in the foreign land, you have to see the dignity or strength of your 4th house, which tells about your domestic life, your prospects of your birthplace, your motherland, and you have to also give attention to the house of the foreign settlement. Whichsoever thing you will find gaining more strength or losing out strength is going to give you this idea that in which side or geographical location you are going to do better in the life. And lastly, friends, many times people also ask me this question, where people have this provision of selecting a specific region or a country of their choice. Like for example, you want to move to a foreign country on the basis of education, like going for higher studies and all. So for example, if you are based in India, you are open to the options of Australia or Canada or like New Zealand. So friends, if you actually want to calculate it from this logical perspective, although there are so many techniques which we will discuss in a standalone separate video, but one way, one simple concise way of finding out is just try to find out where your 9th house lord is present and placed in the main ascendant chart. So because you know that the 10th house represents the south direction, the 4th house represents the north direction, the 1st house represents the east direction, and you can further divide it in a different direction as well, like for example northeast, like southwest. So then friends, you have to see that where your 9th house lord is deposited in the chart, so that direction from the country you are based in could be one of the alternative way of finding out that which country or which region is going to be best suited for your better growth and prosperity in this life. So that is something, friends, which I wanted to say in this one standalone video. I hope you guys found this video informational. Whatsoever is your views, or if you want to supplement it with some of your own techniques, please feel free to write it on the comment section. So for furthermore updates and notifications on the divine science of Vedic astrology, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and like my Facebook page. Dhanyavad.